So why choose Ubik as a beautiful design fiction as a capitalist present of a capitalist present? We welcome you to the idea of the Ubik. The Ubik is is revolutionary and is an acceleration of the mobile phone, linking the human with machine. This makes this product suitable for all demographics, evidently dependent on which level you choose, which you're later to see in Eric's bit, depending on because there's a certain need for surgery. But why are we selling you this? Well, the only thing holding humanity back is itself. To further mankind against its own weakness, i.e. ill health and the aging process, for it to flourish in years to come is the emergence of humanity with technology. We have already seen throughout our research that this technology is far from being in its infancy, so already the idea strays from the probable into the plausible range. However, we need you, the dragons, to help us make this product turn from the plausible into the actual. Then we've got help with the £10 million and the 20% part of our business. You help us as a stepping stone to humanity's evolution. The money will fund the equipment needed to mass produce the Ubik across the UK, as well as providing areas and hospitals where the Ubik surgery can take place. As this technology will not only help the average citizen, we have got the go-ahead to have a Ubik station within hospitals across the UK. And then for the first year, and then the rest of Europe, and then to the rest of the United States.
This is Ubik.
Ubik.
I don't know why it's called Ubik. That sounds a bit. There was a thing to do with
science
fiction. It's from a Philip K. Dick novel.
Right.
A science fiction novel.
Yeah.
Do you want to
read any of
that?
It's
that one.
Yeah.
Go on then.
We'll just go. Oh, we need the next bit. Yeah. That's
it. Mm.
Right. This is Ubik. There's three modes of Ubik. Am I pronouncing that? Is it Ubik or Ubik?
Ubik, whichever. I've only ever read it. I've said it out loud.
This is the base model. It has basic mobile phone functionality in a stylish anodized magnesium alloy body, which range of colours. It magnetically attaches to your temple and using transducers and read your voice and play music into your head or sound or any sound. The next one?
Sure, so I'll say something about the price.
You say something about the price.
So the demographic for this, for the level one, is for everyone because basically it's like a mobile phone. The starting price for the base model of the Ubik is £649.99. And if you pay that upfront cost, you will then get a reduced monthly tariff rate of between £30 and £50, depending on your tariff of how much data you want, etc. If you don't want to pay the upfront £649.99 price for the Ubik, you will have to sign a six-year fixed-term contract, and that will cost you between £90 and £130 a month, obviously, again, basing on your tariff.
Do you want to go on to level two?
Which is Ubik level two?
Yeah.
We called it Ubik Glass until I realised that was a good
one.
Name pending. Ubik Glass, rather than using a small sheet of perspex so you can see what you're looking at, uses lasers directly into your eye to project images, emails, text messages, social media. So everything that the phone has visually and audibly. forgot about this bit. Has the ability to download information directly into your brain, so you can learn an entire 3 years course, undergraduate degree course, in under 15 seconds.
Yeah. So based on research that I did on Apple Watches, Google Glass, etc., we based the Ubik Glass retail price at between, where is it? £329.99 and £749.99. So, obviously, with Apple Watches and everything, you've always got the option to customize different. You can add gold, diamonds, whatever you want to your Ubik Glass. Obviously, on top of that, you will then have to pay for your downloads, such as if you're going to want to do a degree. The starting prices for a year are £9,250 for an undergraduate degree.
Is the brain surgery free?
Yeah, that all comes in with the
price.
Brain
surgery.
Yeah, minor brain surgery.
A small drill into your temple.
Obviously, the demographic for this product would still be the same people that wanted the UBIC, and obviously students like ourselves that want to do degrees. There is negotiations to be able to look into loans to be able to do your degree by downloading it.
This is UBIC Hive. UBIC Hive creates a hive mind, which is linked to every other UBIC Hive in that particular workforce. It is connected to UBIC Hub and is controlled via that. And sorry, I forgot everything I was going to say. So it creates a strong workforce, everybody working together as one army. And it is directed towards the military applications.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we based the last product on high earning individuals and the military. So that's why the retail price of UBIC Hive is between £90,000 and £120,000. And this research was based on the top 10 highest earning individuals in America at the moment. So, Paul was saying earlier about how obviously we want to eventually go across over the whole world, globalise this product. So obviously we've got five regions that we would like to put our product into, and the the numbers represent how many units we would sell in each country based on their population, and then we would hope to reach 30% of the population from each region. It's very complicated.
So is that based purely on population rather than access to money?
Yeah. Okay, so this is the sales for the standard UBIC in the first year of production. This is what we plan to sell throughout the year. Obviously it's very up and down, depending on marketing, when we remarket the product. Yeah, but you look at the peaks. then these are the sales for UBIC Glass. I'm not going to bore you. And then UBIC Hive. Basically, based on all the number crunching, and I'm not a numbers person, I estimated that our gross annually revenue for a year, are you ready?
Yes.
Is, when I can find the sheet that it says it on, 59,613,750,000 pounds.
Pounds?
Yes, pounds. This isn't pounds. So obviously we would like 10 million. And how much? 20%. Yeah, we want 10 million for 20% of the company. Yeah. But yeah, it's a very good return. And that is even obviously a good portion of that for the the UBIC Hive. Thank you. That was only estimating that we would sell 150 units a month of the UBIC Hive, obviously at the highest ending price, which is £120,000. So it's not that meant to sell. I'm taking a good chance. Yeah, now say your little bit.
Okay, right.
Your
so
conclusion.
Taking all this and to how it will break down society, so like the further acceleration, so pushing it to its breaking point, what we've got here, is essentially it'll become, we won't know what we don't even know, because say the phrase of just Google it, just like internet search it, would change to just Ubik it, because it would be part of our consciousness, essentially, if you go for the highest range. So if socially dependent on technology, what if it fails, like viruses, some sort of element that, like if there's something that goes wrong, you can't download something, it will stop you from, knowledge is lost, so now there's a miscommunication for knowledge, and that's how essentially society will break down from that. Because you won't essentially know, if you're just downloading it, and won't know previously, just rely on social media, or Google to get your answers.
That's it.
Is that, that's it?